We are the only country that haven't had any restrictions on our regulation, how to explore, how to do the commercializations of fisheries. Mm-hmm. Like everybody just can come, catch, do anything, mm-hmm. catch anything, any size, mm-hmm. any method. Di dunia, di Eropa, di Australia, di New Zealand, semua ada aturannya. How many months they can catch, what size they can take, and license is also quite numbers of government get back the compensation. A license of lobster, an example, is almost $1 million, I think more even $1 million in Australia to get the license to catch lobster for certain months, for certain size only. Di kita, do we have that? No.
Gak ada license selama ini untuk penangkapan.
Aturan ada, Bu. Enforcement-nya tidak ada. So, if you see numbers dari subsidi yang tadi, 11 triliun, itu sementara kita cuma dapat BNBP-nya 300 miliar. I will request to Mr. President to stop the subsidy, give the money to us, to give it to all the fishermen on the coastal line. See, you know, well, I mean, in the end, a country is an enterprise. If what we spend, it's not equal with what we earn, it's like an enterprise, we'll be bankrupt. Yeah. I don't know, I mean, I'm not so sure why. Mungkin karena my education background which is not appropriate for the position,
it
can be, but can be also with the way I am putting the fact to the table, because I'm a straightforward person. Possible the country not used to it yet, so other than that, you might know, you answer your questions. They're not really happy with the system and everything, so it just thought it's not for me. I'm not suitable for a school. I don't say school not suitable for me, but it's more me is not it's not suitable for my things. School it's a good thing, but my way it's not suitable to the system. So I decided to quit study and start small business with. Yeah, buying, selling bed cover, and then some clothes, some thing, and then I met a fisheries businessman, and we married, and we started the business. Realizing the company is small, not big capital, and realizing the advantage, the big advantage of small fishing industry, so small boat, so that means daily catching, freshness is. We are above everybody, and the cold storage in Pangandaran. So that then I decide to make start from the beginning. We don't want to treat our product with any chemical. So we say it's friendly environment. We don't wash our product with chlorine. We don't wash our product with any chemical additive. So it's pure, original, the way genuine seafood. That's what I want to sell. Because that's the only way to be different in market, to catch the eyes and the interest of people. My simple way of thinking. And then the crisis come, so it was a blessing in disguise, because the dollars went up from 2,700 to 17,000, escalate our business, fishermen happy. And then I see the top level of seafood is freshness, life. And that's why we're thinking to get the plane, because lack of infrastructure in the country make transportation take so long. It's 12 hours to Jakarta from our village. The mortality is very high, but convincing the bank that mortality rate can pay $2 million aircraft is not easy. It's take me 4 years to get the money from the bank, and finally we got it, and then we had the plane for 1 month. Tsunami happened, so we went to start the tsunami relief for 2 weeks, carry $50,000 about, paying fuel, everything, give everybody flights for free. 2 weeks after the money finished, I would like to go back to my fisheries. But many NGOs, please keep the plane here, we need it. So we keep the plane and start chartering our aircraft. Mm-hmm. And then we have another one, we have another one. We had 200 to 250 flights a day. Last year we had 57,000 flights, 43,500 hours. We are flying now to 204 routes and 163 destinations. 90% is unique to us, to Suzy Air. Things to sustain your activity as a business. I think whatever, you need to put commercializations or business common sense on it. If not, it won't sustain. That's one thing. The second is good governing on doing anything. Put your best integrity and sincere, because you deal also with people, no? Especially me with small fishermen. And I believe I learned a lot from a Japanese culture to be always straight. So that's make your job also easier, because you don't have to go around, oh, I have to fix this, I have to fix that. You just have to go ahead. The combination of total commitment, your integrity is always number one, very important part. People will respect and appreciate you. That's your value. And the third is genuine and sincere. That's what makes me probably different. And in marketing being different, I heard it's a good point.